everyone, I'm Vanna Singh and you are watching 99.9 Engineering Station. I will be starting a new subject, that is Engineering Thermodynamics. This is the very first lesson. In this, we will study the basics and from the next lecture, we will start a laws of thermodynamics. I will be requesting you all that please follow this subject from the very beginning, otherwise you get difficulty to understand the advanced level of thermodynamics. Actually, this subject is very much numerical based. For that, your concept should be very clear. And one more thing is that the gate weightage is also very high for this subject. So without further delay, let's start the today's lesson. So as the name indicates that the thermodynamics is basically a power development from the heat. And the thermodynamics is also used in the many subjects like heat transfer, mass transfer and fluid. So you can say that the thermodynamics deals with the conversion of work into a heat and heat into a work. It tells the whether the reaction is possible or not. Thermodynamics also tells us that the reaction is possible or not. And the one more thing, more important thing is that it does not tell us about the rate. Thermodynamics never tells about the rate. Why? Because we know that the rate is equal to the driving force upon resistance. Here, the driving force is the thermodynamic property, but the resistance is non-thermodynamic property. How? So, as you see, the heat, in the case of heat transfer, rate formula is Q is equal to delta T upon X K A. This is the resistance term, X upon K A. Here, this total formula is the Fourier's law, and here in this formula X upon Ka is the resistance. Here the X is the length, K is the thermodynamic property and A is the area of cross section. So X is not a thermodynamic, length is not a thermodynamic property, K is the property of material, that is also not thermodynamic property, and area is also not a thermodynamic property. So therefore the resistance is non-thermodynamic property. That's why thermodynamics not tells about the rate, because its ratio of rate is not thermodynamic property. Now come to the next important terms which are used in the thermodynamic subject very frequently till the end of the subject. That is, first term is system. What is system? System is basically a object under investigations. Suppose we are going to study any reactor like CSTR. We have to calculate its volume, conversion and etc. So the our system in this case our reactor, that is CSTR, because we are going to investigate it. So the object of investigation is system. Now another important term is surrounding. Now what is surrounding? Surrounding is the point tells where the influence of system can be felt. Where the influence of the system can be felt means after except system, remaining thing which affects the system is called, felt by the system is called surrounding. Next term is universe. Universe is the combination of system plus surrounding, means system plus surrounding is equal to universe. Next term is control volume. Control volume is the volume in which the entire mass of the system is residing. Okay, these are the common terms which are used very frequently until the end of the subject. So you understand it very well. Now the next topic is type of system. So the type of systems are three types. First one is open system, closed system and isolated system. Open system in which we can change mass and energy both. In the closed system, we only change the energy but not mass. And the third case is isolated system. In this case, we neither change the mass and nor the energy. So these are the very common or simple words, types of system. So simple to understand. Next topic is thermodynamic property. Here, there are three types of thermodynamic property. First one is intensive property. Second is extensive property. And third is specific property. So start with the intensive property. Intensive property is independent of mass. It is a property which is independent of mass, like temperature, pressure, density, viscosity, dynamic viscosity and refractive index. These are all are independent of mass. Next is extensive property. Extensive property is just opposite to intensive property, means it is dependent on the mass, like all the energies. I have written down here that all the E's, jitne bhi energies hain, like internal energy, enthalpy, Gibbs free energy, entropy, volume and mass. Volume and mass both are depend upon the mass of the system. That's why it comes into a extensive properties. Next is specific property. The specific property is a special case of intensive property. Why? Actually, it is the ratio of two extensive property and it becomes an intensive property. For example, if we use Q upon M, both are depend upon the mass and their ratio will be specific property, intensive property. Okay. Now, from here, we understand some basics of thermodynamics. Let's start with the force. What is force? Force is simply mass into acceleration and its unit, SI unit is Newton. And weight is mass into gravity. It's also, its weight unit is also Newton. So another question is come is that the difference, what is the difference between the force and weight? The only difference between it is that in the weight we consider the acceleration due to gravity. We multiply mass into acceleration due to gravity, but in the force we simply consider the acceleration. So the force is equal to 1 upon gc into ma. From here we calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity is 9.80665 kg meter kg force per second square, and 1 kg force is equivalent to the 9.8066 newton. Okay, the next topic is about thermodynamic work. In this we have number of cases. So start with the first case, that is compression. In this case, suppose we have a control volume, and this is the control volume, and this particular term is the piston of for controlling the control volume. So we are applying a pressure from onto the piston, and the volume before the volume of control volume is V1, and after applying the pressure P, the volume will be decreases by dx, and then the volume we get is V2. So in this case the pressure inside, why volume reduces, because pressure inside is smaller than the pressure applied. The pressure of gas inside the control volume is less than the pressure we are going to apply. That's why this piston moves inward and the volume will decreases. So what will happen? We know that dW is equal to force into displacement. So in this case, if we resolve the component of displacement, then dW is equal to force dx. We know that the work is the dot product of force into displacement. So after removing, we get dW is equal to F dx cos theta. Here the theta term is equal to zero, because since the force and the displacement is in the same direction, we are applying this force in this direction, and the displacement decrease in the volume is also take place in this direction. That's why the theta value will be zero. So the cos zero is equal to one. So the work done is equal to force into displacement only. Now what happens? What we write down the force in terms of, we can write force as a pressure into area, and dx, as we know that the volume is meter cube and area is meter square. We cancel out both, then what we get? Meter. So instead of writing dx, we can write dv upon a. So the equation will become dw is equal to minus time p integration v1 to v2 dv. Here we added negative sign because v1 is greater than v2, and v2 minus v1 we get negative sign. So we inserted negative sign in the equation already. That's why we cannot get the work done in negative. Okay, this formula is very important. You should learn it very thoroughly. Next case is the case of expansion. In the case of expansion, we again have a control volume filled with the gas and one piston. In this case, we are applying a pressure from the piston as we do in the previous case. But in this case, the pressure applied is less than the pressure inside the control volume. So that what happened? The pistons move backward. So if the piston move backwards, so what will happen? Volume will increases. Volume increases means V2 is greater than V1. So in this case, work done will become dW is equal to F into dx cos theta. In this case, theta is equal to 180 degree we consider. Why? Since force and displacement are opposite to each other, that's why we are going to take it in 180 degree value, and the cos 180 degree is equal to also 1. So the work done will come minus F dx. Sorry for the background sound. My son is creating some noise. So sorry for that. So continue. In this case, dW is equal to minus P V1 to V2 dV. So finally, in this case also, we get the work done value minus PdV. Okay, now the next, so there are some conclusion, that is, on compression work is positive, work done is positive, we get the work done is positive, means work is done on the system by the surrounding, work is on the system by the surrounding. While on the expansion, work done is negative, means work done by the system on the surrounding. You can see in the case of expansion, you can see here that in the case of expansion, the value of theta is 180, means force and displacement both are acting in the opposite direction. So the cos 180 is -1. So we get the work done is negative in the case of expansion. So the conclusion is that on the expansion, work done is negative, means work is done by the system on the surrounding. Okay, so let's start. We have clear the concept with a small example, that is the temperature T on the thermodynamic scale is given by, in Kelvin, T is equal to A ln K plus K B, and A, B are constant. The value of K is 1.83 at ice point, and K value is 6.81 at steam point. Then what will be the temperature corresponding to K is equal to 2.42. Okay, we know the expression for temperature, and the value of K will be given on both the situation, at ice point and at the steam point. So the solution, what will be the given data is ice, at ice point temperature is 273.15 Kelvin and the value of K is 1.85. And at steam point, the temperature is 373.15 Kelvin and the value of K is 6.8. So after equating and solving this equation by the simple mathematical method, we get the value of A is 76.21 and the value of B is 227.09. And we put the value of, if we put the value of A and B, which is solved here with a simple mathematical concept, then we get temperature is equal to 76.21 ln 2.42 plus 227.07. And after solving the ln term, we finally get the value of temperature is 294.4 Kelvin, and in case of if we convert into a degree Celsius, the value of temperature should be 21.29. Okay, the next topic is about heat. So what is heat? A hot object brought in contact with a cold object become cooler, whereas the cold object become warmer. If we put brought a hot object with a cold object become, so what will happen? The hot object become cooler and cold object become hotter. As we all know that this concept, heat is always flow from higher temperature to the lower temperature. This is also known. Okay, first is known, second is known. Third is, this lead to the concept of temperature as the driving force for the temperature of energy as the heat. So in this case, the concept of temperature as the driving force for the temperature transfer of energy. In the case of heat, the driving force is temperature for transferring the energy as a heat. Okay? Next is heat and work is a transient form of energy. It never being stored. Heat and work is a transient form of energy. It never can be stored. Okay. The next topic is zeroth law, which we will cover in the next lesson. So if you have any doubt regarding the basics, please let me know. Till then, thank you very much.